A question which I'm often asked is how do you build a trading system? So in today's video, I'll explain how do you actually build a trading system and what all steps are involved in building a trading system. So the first step in building a trading system is data cleaning. You need to make sure that your data is clean, continuous and has no missing values and is adjusted for all events. So for example, if you're trading in the cash market, you need to make sure that your data is adjusted for dividend, stock splits, etc. If you're trading in the futures, you need to make sure that your futures data it continues. If you're trading options, you need to make sure that wherever there are missing values, you need to either backfill or forward fill your data. So first thing is getting your data right before doing any sort of analysis. The second step in system building is strategy idea. So strategy idea could be your market observations, your hypothesis about the market. For example, what if I buy a stock which closes above yesterday's high? What if I sell a stock that closes below yesterday's low? Do I make money or no? So this is an idea and you need to actually test it out before putting actual money. So the third step has actually 5 sub steps. So first is entry logic. What will trigger your buy or sell? It should be predefined and should be written in simple language. So let me give you an example. What if I buy a stock which has closed above the R1 pivot in the 5-minute time frame intraday? So my entry logic is buy above the high of the 5-minute candle which closes above R1 pivot. So this is my clear entry logic. So the second step is stop loss. So if you're buying above a candle which has closed above R1, what will be your stop loss? So for example, let the stop loss be the low of that candle. So okay, so entry is defined. Stop loss is also defined. So third step is exit logic. How will you close your trade? So there are a lot of different ways to do that. Either you exit your trade at a predefined profit or you trail your stop loss. So for example, if you buy a stock above the 5-minute candle high of R1 pivot, your stop loss is the day low. Suppose the stop loss was 10 points. So basically that is your R. So you can either exit at 1 R, 50% you can exit at 1 R, or you can keep trailing. So there are different ways to it. We'll discuss this more in future videos. But the first step was entry logic. Second was stop loss. The third was exit. The fourth step is risk per trade. It's basically how much risk you want to take on a single trade. It should be within 1 or 2% of your capital depending on your risk appetite. So for example, your capital is 10 lakhs and you want to risk 1% on a single trade. So 1% of 10 lakhs is 10,000. So no matter how sure you are about that setup, you will make sure that you don't lose more than 10,000 on that trade. So fifth step is position sizing. It is basically how much quantity you will buy or sell as per your risk per trade. So if the formula is position sizing is equal to risk amount divided by your stop loss. So suppose your capital is 10 lakh, you want to risk 1% on a trade. So 1% of 10 lakhs is 10,000. So that is your risk amount. So what, suppose your stop loss is 100 points. So 10,000 divided by 100. Basically, you'll trade 100 quantities in that instrument. Suppose your stop loss is bigger. Suppose it's 1,000. So you'll trade 10 quantities. Suppose your stop loss is smaller. It's 10 points. So you'll trade 1,000 quantities. But you can see that in no case, you lose more than 10,000 because depending on your stop loss, you are trading your quantity. So if your stop loss is bigger, your quantity is smaller. But if your stop loss is smaller, your quantity is bigger. But your risk on each and every trade is 1% of your capital. The fourth step is generate a trade log. So basically, whatever rules you have defined for your system, if you had followed them, what all trades would have been taken in the past? So a trade log is basically a journal which contains each and every trade that have been taken as per your trading logic, the entry signal, the exit signal, entry price, exit price, everything in detail as per your rules that you have defined for the system. The fifth step is equity curve. It is basically a plot of the cumulative P&L. It tells you how your capital has grown over time if you had followed this strategy, this trading logic. The sixth point, which is important, is the backtest report. I'll explain backtesting in very much detail in further videos, but to give an idea, backtest basically helps you discard or accept your strategy depending on few metrics. So the few important metrics, as you can see on the screen, are max drawdown amount. As we discussed, a loss of 20%, you need 25% to break even. So you need to make sure that your drawdown is within your risk limit. I prefer a drawdown of less than 20% for my strategy. Another important point is payoff ratio. As I said, that every trade you take, you should make more money if you are right. So payoff ratio is basically how much money you make when you are right and how much you lose when you are wrong. So that should be greater than 1.5, which means basically on a winning trade, you are making 1.5 times of the risk you take. There are many more such terms in backtesting, which I'll explain in further video, because backtesting itself is a very big concept in itself. The seventh step is optimizing the trading strategy. So as you saw that a strategy is built through market hypothesis and market observations. So you thought that buying above the 5-minute candle high could give profits, but it could not be the case. So you can optimize the strategy by changing the entry conditions, stop loss conditions and the exit conditions. And you can do that by observing the trade log which you have maintained for your strategy. So you can see that what if I, instead of exiting the stock at a 1 hour profit, what if I exit the stock at 315? Does it give me more money or no? What if I change the stop loss? Does it give me more money or no? So you can make various combinations and then decide what is the best condition for your strategy. That is how you optimize your strategy. So eighth step is evaluating the robustness of your system. So you need to check for slippages, the risk involved and the liquidity cost if you are trading this strategy. And you need to make sure that your strategy is making money in most market conditions. So robustness, you check that whether your strategy is scalable or not. The ninth step is track the real-time performance. So before actually deploying your strategy with full capital, you start with a smaller quantity to get a feel of the strategy. What this will do is it will give you some few more insights before you actually deploy a larger money on your strategy. Other additional points to consider while building a trading system are, you check the trading system performance on black swan event days. Like what happened to your trading strategy on a black swan event day in the past. You check the performance by removing the outliers. Why this is important is, so for example, if you're trading an option buying system and you see that for 100 trades, you don't make money. But even if one trade gives you a profit of 400 times, 200 times, overall the system will be profitable. But if you remove just that one trade, overall the system is net negative. So you need to remove outliers from your trading system. It's basically the top 10% wins and the top 10% losses. You need to make sure that the strategy gives consistent performance quarter by quarter, year by year. It is acceptable within your risk limits and there's stable winning and losing runs. Basically, the max winning streak and max losing streak should be comfortable as per your risk appetite. I hope you all got a good idea of what all goes into building a trading system. I've just given a brief idea. There's much more to it and cover these things in much more detail in further videos. But I hope this is a good starting point. So I'll again iterate whatever we discussed today. So the first step is data cleaning. Don't make the mistake of directly going into system building. You need to make sure that your data is clean. The second step is strategy idea. It will come through market observations or hypothesis. So third step has many sub-steps. The first is entry logic, stop loss, exit logic, risk per trade and position sizing. The fourth step is generating the trade log. So basically you generate trades that would have been taken as per your system in the past and you keep a log of it. The fifth step is the equity curve. It basically tells you how your capital has grown over time. The sixth step is the backtest report. It helps you discard or accept your strategy based on certain metrics. It could be max drawdown, risk to reward ratio, winning streak, losing streak, etc. We'll discuss these things in further videos. The seventh step is optimizing the strategy. The eighth step was evaluating the robustness for your system. Is your system scalable or not? The ninth step is tracking real-time performance. So you basically test your strategy on a smaller capital before deploying a larger capital. I hope you liked the video and found it insightful. Let me know in the comment section what topics you want me to cover next. Thank you.